Hi, this is Damian, and in this video, I'll show you how you can use cloud-hosted agents to build on Mac, Windows, or Linux without needing to manage infrastructure of your own. I have a Xamarin Forms project for iOS and Android, plus a web API for the backend written in ASP.NET Core. In this scenario, I want to build all of these projects at the same time in the same build definition, but each project needs to be built on a different operating system. The iOS project on a Mac, the Android project on Windows, and I'll build the web API project on a Linux machine. So let's have a look at the build definition we've created. I've separated this build definition into three phases, one for each of the projects we want to build. You can add new phases by clicking the ellipses at the top of the definition here. For each of these phases, we can choose the agent that's used to build them, and we have a number of hosted options here. To meet our requirements, we're building the iOS app with the hosted Mac agent, which is inherited from the default for our build definition. We're using the hosted VS2017 agent for the Android app, and for the web API, we're using the hosted Linux agent. These agents are provisioned and managed by VSTS, so you don't have to worry about running them on your own machines. We spin them up and tear them down on demand. In each of these phases, we're building the project, then uploading the artifacts to a drop folder in VSTS, where they can be used later as part of a release. You can get an idea of the capabilities of each of these hosted agents by going to the Agent Queues Administration page and choosing Capabilities. Each hosted queue contains a virtual agent that shows you some of the tools that will be installed. Let's go back to our build page and queue a new build. Now, as the build is running, you can see that each of the agent phases is being run independently in whichever order agents are made available. However, if you need to, you do have the option of making phases dependent on each other. For example, if you had a common library that was used by all the other phases, you can add those dependencies to the phase in the build definition. On completion of the build, you can see that the artifacts from each of those agent phases has been uploaded to VSTS, and they're available all in the same place. We can use the hosted agents both in build definitions and also in release definitions. This is useful in scenarios where you might need to run certain deployment tasks on specific operating systems. So there you have it. Hosted build agents are a great option for your builds, no matter what platform you require.